What is up, guys? It's Tommy here, and welcome to the Liverpool Middlesbrough post-match analysis show. And guys, Liverpool are in the Champions League if we get through the qualifiers, but still, this is a massive achievement. And this caps off, I think, a really, really good season for Liverpool and Jurgen Klopp. Remember, the second half of the season wasn't as good as the first half, but still Liverpool had to withstand a lot of pressure from the chasing pack, especially Arsenal. So let me know, guys, what did you think of the game in the comments below, and how far do you think Liverpool will go in the Champions League? I think we will be seeded in the qualifiers, so hopefully, touch wood, Liverpool will get an easy draw in the Champions League qualifiers. The draw for that will be on August the 4th, so mark that in your calendar. And, you know, because Dortmund finished third in the Bundesliga and qualified straight away in for the Champions League, you know, there are not that many, you know, great seeded teams even in the Champions League qualifiers. And Arsenal, for the first time in 21 years, will only play Europa League football. And I think overall Liverpool have deserved it. In the first half of the season, Liverpool collected 43 points. That was actually, you know, we could have finished second if we collected the same amount of points in the second half of the season. Second half of the season wasn't as good. We only collected 33 points. Liverpool really, really, I think, deserved it, because we played some magnificent football. And when the pressure was on, Liverpool dropped a lot of points in January, February. When the pressure was on, Liverpool pulled off really impressive victories. Stoke away, West Brom away, West Ham away. Those were three absolutely massive wins. Watford away as well, which was vital. And when Liverpool were under massive pressure, because Arsenal won the last five games of their season, you know, when Liverpool were under pressure, we had bags of steel about us. We won 4-0 against West Ham and 3-0 against Middlesbrough, and actually the nerves were there, and it was very evident in this game, because Liverpool didn't start the game firing on all cylinders. Man City were already 1-0 up after like 3 minutes. Arsenal were 1-0 up after 8 minutes. So the pressure was on Liverpool to score, and to score early against Middlesbrough, and we just couldn't break down the double-decker bus that they parked at Anfield. We huffed and puffed. We had a lot of shots from outside the area, with almost the full defense standing in front of the likes of Coutinho. Sturridge was pretty lively. He created some chances out of nothing. He just couldn't hit the target. And I absolutely loved Jurgen Klopp's reaction in the 33rd minute when Sturridge dragged his shot wide. He was really pumping up the crowd, because he sensed that Anfield went a little bit flat. And Jurgen Klopp, you know, he was full of emotion, you know, living each second throughout the game, and I think that helped massively, because after that I noticed the Anfield crowd was a lot louder. And yeah, our biggest worry this season was breaking down teams who park the bus, both at home and away from home. And I think we can rectify that with signings. We need a quicker left back who has quite a lot of pace, and because both Klein and Milner are really pedestrian, they can't really go past the fullbacks with pace, and we rely on them a lot with our formation. So I think we need faster fullbacks, and also we need a brand new left winger who is electric, which will allow Coutinho to play in the number 10 role, or the number 80 role, sorry. And also it would be a great replacement for Sadio Mane. The first goal actually came from the last attack of the first half. Klein passes it to Firmino, who first time finds Wijnaldum on the edge of the area. He takes the ball inside, and then he absolutely buries it. And Wijnaldum had such a great season. He now scored, I think, 6 goals. All of them were at home at Anfield. And you could see Jurgen Klopp's emotion when the ball went in. It meant so, so much, and you will be able to see my fans on live reactions about the game after this video. Probably after like 8 or 9 p.m. I will upload it, so make sure to leave a like on this video if you are looking forward to it. And that lifted the whole crowd. Anfield erupted. That was such a huge moment in our whole season. And this result And the fact that we qualify for the Champions League could shape Liverpool's future for the next few years at least, because I think we will be able to attract really big players now with Champions League football, the likes of Van Dijk, Naby Keita, even Lacazette, for example. We could attract these kind of players with Champions League football, and without Champions League football, we wouldn't have as big a chance of getting all these players. And also, some of the biggest names of Arsenal might leave without Champions League football. I can't see Sanchez playing Europa League next season. And Ozil might leave as well, so, and that would leave Arsenal very depleted, because Arsenal are nothing special without Sanchez. They would have actually struggled to even come anywhere near the top four. And Coutinho scores a magnificent free kick just after like half time in the 50th minute. Brad Guzan takes a step towards his left, and Coutinho just curls it into the bottom right corner. It bounced up over Guzan's hand, and that was a magnificent free kick. And at 2-0, I was 100% certain we will make it, because Middlesbrough offered virtually no threat. I have to also mention that there was a really, really nervy moment in the first half. At 0-0, Lovren, he tries to defend a one-on-one with the striker, and actually for a second or a split second Lovren puts his hand on the striker's shoulder. Bamford goes down very, very easily, and I think it was a dive, so the referee doesn't give anything. But of course Arsenal fans were screaming for a penalty. But Arsenal fans, you shouldn't rely on the referee for you guys to get top four. You should have you should be just good enough to get top four on your own. So, and Liverpool got away with it, I will say, because some referees give that as a penalty, some referees don't. And you know, after the second goal, Coutinho's goal went in, Middlesbrough really just had lost all the belief. And it was actually a brilliant counter-attack from a Middlesbrough corner where Liverpool found the third goal from. Wijnaldum passes it across the box, and Klein leaves it to Lallana, who takes a touch inside the area and slots it home past the goalkeeper. And Mignolet actually made a couple of good saves. And I have to say that huge credit goes to Mignolet and to the whole Liverpool defense, because we finished the season with four clean sheets in a row, and that is unheard of. I can't remember the last time we kept four clean sheets in the Premier League in a row. It was probably in the Rafa Benitez era, like 7 or 8 years ago, something like that. Let me know if you have a statistics for that. But yeah, actually we finished on only 42 goals conceded, which is still, you know, not the best, but at least it's not around the 50 goal mark, which usually happens. And Liverpool, of course, should have scored even more goals. Wijnaldum had some chances, Sturridge, and especially Firmino had some chances. And I think this formation, Firmino and Sturridge up front, it looks like a banging formation with the 4-4-2 diamond wide, because both Firmino and Sturridge can create chances out of nothing. And Sturridge, you know, was again very lively, and it unsettled the Middlesbrough defense. And Coutinho in the number 8 role is much more effective. He can affect the game, you know, put defense splitting passes towards the strikers. And oh my goodness, Sturridge had a long shot, which if it goes in, it would have been one of the goals of the season from like 25, 26 yards. He tries to curl it into the top corner. So the most important thing, Liverpool are in the Champions League qualifiers. We just have to get through that, and then we are into the Champions League group stages. And remember, Liverpool are the most successful English club in Europe with 5 Champions League and 3 Europa League trophies. And I'm really looking forward to next season now, because especially with the new signings, I think Liverpool will be a team that you have to count on. And I expect Liverpool to actually qualify until the quarterfinals, and then of course it will depend who we get in the Champions League group stages. I expect Liverpool to knock out, you know, a low seeded team, a non-seeded team, sorry, in the Champions League qualifiers. So unless major disaster happens, Liverpool should be good enough to go through to the group stage. And then, you know, European nights at Anfield are so, so special. So bring it on. I can't wait to witness Liverpool playing Champions League football again. Remember that, you know, back in the Rafa Benitez days, Liverpool were regularly in Champions League finals, in Champions League semi-finals, in Champions League quarter-finals. At what point throughout the, yeah, like 1.5, 2 years, we were actually the number one team in Europe between 2006 and 2008, I think, where we played like two Champions League finals, two Champions League semi-finals as well. So bring it on. I can't wait to, you know, see Anfield on a European night, on a Champions League night. That will be special. Really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Remember that the Fanzone live reactions are coming later tonight, and also the career mode videos are back now that I'm back from my short holiday, so stay tuned. Thanks for watching. See you later, guys. Goodbye.